For what reason?
Taxis. Oh, brother, okay.
Wait. You know how every year they change the kisa? When the kisa of the Kaaba, when it falls off, that means the Kaaba doesn't have no taxis off.
Exactly. It doesn't matter if they're changing or not. What do you mean?
It makes no sense.
Because why don't you put a kisa on the houses of Allah as a
Masjid? Okay, here's another argument.
Because here's another argument. Special.
Here's another argument. The kisa went on the Ahlul Bayt once, the kisa on the Kaaba is all year. So what, now they take off the kisa, they're not on the
Muslims. So when Muhammad put the kisa on him, what's that mean?
Well, it makes no sense. The argument is literally...
So what's mean when Muhammad put the kisa?
He wanted to stand
there. Of course. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها
عن أم
سلمة
both of them قيل أدخل رسول الله علينا فجلس فوضع الكساء فقال لي علي وفاطمة ادخلي ثم أتى الحسن والحسين فجلس على فخذتي رسول الله فقال اللهم فاشهد إن هذا أهل بيتي إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجال البيت
ويطهركم
هذا حديث من عائشة عن أم سلمة رضي الله عنهما that they say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walked in and he sat down and he said to Ali and Fatima to come under the kisa, which is like a cloak, and al-Hasan and al-Husayn also came in and sat on the laps of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, oh Allah, bear testimony that these are my Ahlul Bayt, and Allah made
the
then he says the ayah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So the Prophet identified who Ahlul Bayt are.
Okay.
Simple as. So the ayah of the purification says, "Inna ma yuridu Allah li yudhiba 'ankum Ahlul Bayt." So why do you want to bring in the wives and the beginning of it? The Prophet. The Prophet matched that action.
Did his wife try to answer the kisa?
To the verse of the Quran. The Prophet explained who Ahlul Bayt are. So now that's one point.
فالإئمة من بعد الحسين the imams after Hussein.
Why are you changing the subject? It's a question. I'm concentrating on Ahlul Bayt.
They haven't been born yet.
Clarify all misconceptions.
Because you said, you said
Ahlul Bayt, the wives are part of Ahlul Bayt. No, but not those Ahlul Bayt. We agree, okay, his wives are his Ahlul Bayt, generally speaking. Your wife is your Ahlul Bayt. That's also, we're not arguing about
general.
That. We're talking about the Ahlul Bayt that the Prophet identified. And the ones that were implied in the verse of the purification. That's it. Now, question. What does طهركم تطهيرا إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجس
to purify them a purification
of what?
Of what? Of what? Of which? And if I don't know if I'm not mistaken المفيد he said بذاك هو الشك
not only the shek if you look at the verses in the Quran the rich came with many meanings one of them is the shek the other is عمل الشيطان الخبائث yeah so many things so it's purification Allah wanted right so to just establish that it's not the part of the wives because they were not purified because of we see that if Allah distanced them kept away from them all these bad things. We don't expect them to do this bad thing, correct? So we see, for example, Aisha, yes, went against Allah's word. Yes, Allah said, don't tabarruj. Listen, let me finish. Allah said, وَلَا تَبَرُّجُ تَبَرُّجَ الْجَهَلِيَةُ الْأُولَى وَقَرْنَ فِي بِيُوتِكَ
Stay.
وَلَا تَبَرُّجَ Both of them is a mandate on the wives of the Prophet to stay at home and do not go. Allah made him special.
Ali.
Allah made him special.
I can recite your poem about Ali.
Yeah. So why this got protection? Why you have something in your heart about him?
I know you.
So why do you bring him always? When they said the No. That's normal.
No.
We always do that.
No, Muhammad, Masha, Raf, Shafoni, Dhakko. I know them.
When they praised Imam Ali, did they insult the Sahaba? So why did you react like
this?
No, wait.
They say Allah Akbar. What are you talking about?
I said Allah Akbar with you.
What I'm saying is the wives of the Prophet, Aisha, did not stay at home as Allah instructed her. And she went with an army against the Imam Ali. That is to us, and also in the verse of the Quran, Allah threatened them with a surah of tahreem.
Okay. I'm giving you incidents to prove my point
that they were not purified, Habibi. Because if you were purified, they would not commit sins. You understand me?
This is from your understanding. Okay.
Let me establish.
I allowed you to speak.
Sure.
So but when I speak, you don't.
The reason I said this, I wanted to understand your understanding of the purification. And you correctly defined it. You correctly said what it was. And then when I brought you the example of Aisha to say, look, the wives are not included in that part of the verse.
Okay.
Yes? Give me your why you don't disagree with me.
Yalla, Zain. When Allah brought down this ayah, the ayah muhkama is clear. And the ayah, it clearly, when you read the ayat, the one before it, the ayah itself and after it, is talking about who? It's talking about ummahatul mu'mineen. So the conversation is all talking about ummahatul mu'mineen.
Hey. Giving them instructions only.
No.
He's not saying I'm gonna purify.
No.
He said no.
These are stay
at home. Don't go outside. Yes.
And then he said du'a. Inna ma yurid. And why? What's the reason for this?
Huh?
Why stay at home and don't speak like the Yam Jali? No. Wait. I'm getting there.
Not like any
why
other
does
wife?
Allah say?
Allah said
this. Let me come.
Okay. Fadl.
Allah says qarna fi biyutikna. Roughly translate stay at home. Wala tabarrajna. And don't come out like the ways of the ignorance from before, and establish the salah, and establish the zakat, and obey Allah and His Messenger. For what reason? Innama yurid Allah liyuthiba ankum ar-rijsa ahli al-bayt wa yutahhirakum tathira. The reason for all of these commandments that the wives of the Prophet must obey, so that Allah can purify them from their rijis and purify them, such a purification. Allah doesn't stop there, He continues by saying, and recite from your homes the ayat, the verses of Allah and the hikmah, i.e. the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Aisha, Salama, Hafsa, they were all instructed to spread the kalimat la ilaha illallah and the sunnah of Muhammad from in their homes and outside. This is roughly translated, I'm using the ayah. Now he is saying, Ahl al-Kisa. Why did Rasulullah put them tahta al-Kisa? If I was to move hadith al-Kisa, and let's just say hadith al-Kisa never existed,
and we won't have any argument here.
There you go.
Yes.
Sah. So now,
but it does.
I'm getting it. So this ayah is muhkama. It's clear that it came. If the hadith of Kisa was not to exist,
muhkama, we wouldn't be arguing about it.
No, because there's an understanding of Quran and the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Yeah,
understanding. So now, if you move hadith al-Kisa, and we take the and we take the ayah how it is, we understand it to come down on who? The mothers of the believers. Now, because it came down on the mothers of the believers, Rasulullah, he put Ali, Fatima, Hassan and Hussein, and he included them in this ayah because he loved them. Now someone would say Aisha tried to come inside the Kisa, or Umm Salama tried to come in the Kisa, and Rasulullah said don't come in. This is because Allah has already khassum fil ayah. That Allah has already.
No, why did He tell them you're on good.
Why? What's the good? Because Allah has already said it to them. Antum ala khair. Ma huwa al khair? Al khair huwa ant Allah. Already.
The Prophet had a task.
Allahu Akbar. Aisha. Wait. Let me finish.
Yes.
Okay. Now he said, as you said, أنت على خير. You are on righteousness. خير is you're on good and you're on righteous.
What does that mean?
فذاك means that you don't worry. It's already مخصصة بالآية. This ayah came down on you.
No, I didn't say that.
Why are you denying it?
You speak Arabic.
Is Muslim a word from just Arabic?
Yes.
Who's the first person that spoke the word Muslim?
It's Pharisee.
Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam.
No!
Oh, no,
Prophet Ibrahim, check hadith of Muslim.
Arab.
Prophet Ibrahim called the messenger of the end of time a Muslim as a savior.
Okay.
He is who will save us. He is the one who came to our savior. He is the one that came to us as a savior. You cannot call yourself a Muslim. You can call yourself a practicing Muslim, but you are not practicing the sunnah of the Prophet.
Sallallahu
alayhi wa alihi wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi
wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La.
Bid'ah. This is the bid'ah. This is the bid'ah. The Ahlul Bid'ah wa Jama'ah. The Ahlul Bid'ah. You guys are the Ahlul Bid'ah. You guys copy us. You guys us. You guys are the Ahlul Bid'ah. These people say that the Prophet
said if Muhammad Rasulullah came before Ali sallallahu.
When I just explained,
What comes second?
Listen to me.
That's it.
That's a khalas. No, it's not.
Hello.
I just explained that Islam and Quran became complete on the day of Qadir.
Okay.
By the time it became, how did Islam become complete? It became complete on the day of Qadir by appointment. When Allah told the Prophet to appoint, see, you guys don't listen. You guys don't listen. When Imam Ali,
do you want to debate Ahlul Bayt?
Yes.
Okay.
This guy, anybody who mental.
They are liars. They don't know it.
You know I don't edit. So everything here is live.
What I'm trying to tell you, I keep saying to you, when did this one become popular?
I don't know.
But Allah, does he hide things? Does he hide things from us, or does he want us to know the truth? He wants us to know the truth. Islam became complete on the day of Qadir. I'm telling you, when Imam Ali was appointed as the successor, Islam became complete.
I'm gonna go home and do my research, and next week I'll see you.
You know about the day of Qadir.
I'm learning now. So look, I'm gonna go back. Next week I'll see you. Talk about it.
See, the difference between you and some people is that when we speak, we're trying to learn. These people are here just to deny it. You're not here to deny the truth. You're going to research. I'm trying to educate these brothers. For them, nothing is important. Listen to me now. Islam doesn't start with your Ali. Islam starts with Quran and Ahlul Bayt. Look, okay, where's that from? Stop lying.
What ayat?
You know, liars.
What chapter? What
liars
verse?
Liars and hypocrites go to hell.
Find out for us.
Liars and hypocrites go to hell.
Bro, how am I lying? It's in the Quran.
When you ask someone about Islam, the difference between the truth.
Bro, it's from Quran. He's saying I'm lying. How does that make sense?
Hey, in your books.
What do you mean?
In all your books.
Quran, bro.
We tell you so much stuff that's in the Quran, you deny
like what?
So you don't
like
follow. What? You don't follow the Quran. You don't follow the Quran.
Give me an example, bro.
The highest level that you can reach is Imam.
Show me where the Quran is.
Let me explain to you first.
Show me the ayah,
bro. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam.
Brother,
you know his Quran and Ahlul Bayt. In the six Sahih books, there's no mention of Quran and Sunnah. Anytime, anywhere you find it, it says Quran and Ahlul Bayt. It says Ali alayhi salam. You guys trying to say Ali radiallahu anhu. Yeah? You guys have no respect for the teachings of Quran. You have no respect for the teachings of Quran. The Sunnis choose and select. You choose and select which parts of the Quran you like. You do not take all the teachings from the Quran. You cannot accept some of the words of Allah and deny some of the rest. You cannot do that. That's called a hypocrite. You can't change the meanings of the ayahs. You can't follow the people who disrespected the Prophet and denied him. You cannot. You cannot respect the people who disrespected the Prophet. You cannot respect the people who disrespected the Prophet. Why would you respect somebody who disrespected the Prophet? Don't call yourself a Muslim, a follower of Rasulullah, when you praise the people who disrespected and killed the Prophet. Who disrespected and killed the Prophet? Who disrespected and changed the religion of Islam? They're called Ahle Bidah wa Jama'ah. They're called Ahle Bidah wa Jama'ah. What's your question in regard? And why did you ask it?
What do you say Ali and you don't say Ya Rabbi?
What has that got to do with the basis of Islam? Well done. Allah is Ali. Allah is Ali.